Hey everyone, and welcome or welcome back to the channel. For those of you who are new here, my name is Adriana, and on this channel, I share with you guys my personal journey. Right now, I am doing some inner child work, which I'll get into that in a moment. I also will be talking about spirituality, meditation, possibly yoga, crystals. I recently got introduced to a lot of these concepts and things, and they are super beneficial to me. Oh, one thing I did forget was also affirmations. That's something that is crucial for the season and direction I'm going with my life. And so I'm going to be talking about all of those things. So if that resonates with you, make sure that you definitely like this video, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I make new videos. Yay! Okay, now specifically for this video, what I wanted to tell you guys are just five, and I'm not saying these are the only five, but these are five things I had to know myself and kind of wrap my mind around that I felt would be beneficial to share with you if you decide to do inner child healing. Certain things that you should just expect. That way, when you do it, if you don't come along with me right away, you're like, you know what? I did hear this before. Let me pump my brakes. Let me go ahead and do what I need to do to take this with the right perspective and go on with the right attitude. All right. So in every one of my videos, I will tell you guys, because I don't know when you're jumping in, about the inner child. And then I will go into the topic of the day. So the first thing is your inner child is the first stages of your life. So you can say probably anywhere from when you're born to about eight or so. It's where your subconscious begins to take in a lot of different information. A lot of your inner child absorbs a lot of things from parents and the things that were said or not said, the needs that were met or not met, they actually end up manifesting in your adult self, that if they were not handled correctly, or you were not safe or didn't feel protected, you didn't feel that you can be yourself, if you felt abandoned, if you keep those emotions and they're never addressed or corrected, you become an adult that still can function as an adult, but you're stuck with inner child wounds. So when you work and do inner child work, the process is going back and healing those wounds, and it takes time and it's processing. And then you're able to reparent yourself and be able to correct those wounds so you can have a better life. Stop having self-sabotaging relationships. Stop being in codependent relationships. Stop fearing abandonment. Stop feeling like you're not worthy of anything, or you don't have any value, or that you're going to be stuck, or that you're going to be a statistic. That is what happens when you do inner child work. So now let's get into exactly what I think you should know before you do inner child work, so you don't be sidetracked and being like, whoop, I wish I knew this before I started. Here I am helping you be able to know. And even for me, I have had to go, you know, all right, in order to do this and to do this right, you need to go on with the right perspective and with the right attitude, or this could backfire and be a complete waste of time. And that's one of my pet peeves, y'all. I do not like wasting my time. So the first thing that I'm going to say, I kind of said it earlier and you may have missed it, and that's good, but I'm going to say it again. And this is surprising to me, because I'm a type of person who likes stuff done quickly, right away, instant gratification, why is it taking so long type of person. But I realize with inner child work, there's nothing about this process that I can do to snap my fingers and expedite the process. I realize this is something that is going to take time. I realize that I have to be careful and cautious, and also make my inner child feel comfortable to open up and share so I can pinpoint those wounds. But if I go in and be like, come on, inner child, like shake myself up and be like, come on, this is so frustrating, just tell me, I want to get over it, I'm not going to go anywhere. Just like a child getting reprimanded or yelled at, they're going to curl back into a ball. And if they're already hiding because we pushed them back so far, it's going to go against what I'm trying to do. So I have to just allow myself to do the work in order for my inner child to trust me, and then order to open up so I can really begin the healing process. So just in case you didn't get that, You have to take your time and be patient. You can't compare to anybody else's healing journey. You can't put a time frame on it, because though this is newer to me, I know other people who've come before me that have, you know, been doing inner child healing. They're rocking, they're killing the game. And then 3 or 4 years into their healing, they're like, oh dang, what is this? Panic, and you know, it's just stuff that can come up. So just don't think it's necessarily a one and done. Don't think you can put a time frame on it. Just go with it and be happy that you're making progress. Show up every day for yourself. Be intentional, you know, and just see what happens. I think you'll be very excited about the process. Once you've cried and once you've grieved over those things that didn't happen, you'll be able to free yourself and be a better person. So the next thing that you should kind of expect is that when you're doing your inner child work, guys, you have to understand, this is not for necessarily anybody else. So you're not going into this inner child work expecting to be like, okay, I've done my part as an inner child. Now I need my parents to apologize, and that kind of will give me closure. No. See, the point of inner child work is to target those wounds that you had, right? And then you are able to address them. You're able to validate those feelings because they are valid. Whether you felt abandoned, sad, unworthy, those were valid. And then you allow yourself to be reparented and made felt safe and cared for and loved and appreciated. You don't go ahead and do this process and then expect those people who know you're possibly working on your inner child or anything to be like, oh, well, I'm glad you're doing your inner child work. By the way, I'm sorry. You know, no, we can't do that. And we also have to keep in mind that the people who did do us a lot of harm, or even if it wasn't like harm, it was maybe the lack of that affected us, we are going to have to be able to heal it and then move on with our life if they never say anything else again. So that's what you basically call forgiveness, not saying it didn't happen, but realizing it did happen. It is what it is. And let's just nip it in the bud and move forward. So when you heal, that means it's gone. When your arm is fixed and you mend everything, it's gone. You don't have any more flabby little wrists or whatever. Your arm is healed. Same concept. When you do the work, you address those emotions, you validate yourself, you reparent yourself, and you heal yourself, not involving anyone else in that process in that way. Number three, I have a piece of paper because I know I like to go on tangents and I want to keep it together. So number three is, expect to be uncomfortable. You have to expect that there's going to be some areas and some situations that your inner child is going to remind you of that didn't feel so good. And you're going to be like, oh, whoa, I literally forgot about that. Because I know sometimes we shut down and detach so much as wounded inner children, or our child is so wounded that we really can like shut out years of our life. And even if we wanted to win $1 million, if we could retrieve those memories, they're so far buried. And we have to understand that the questions that we have to ask ourselves, our writing that we have to ask ourselves, any meditation that we do may bring up things, whether you're working with crystals or just doing meditations, or even if you do work with a therapist, there's going to be things that will come back up that will make you uncomfortable. But I don't know if you've heard it. I think you should have. If you're an adult, you have heard that you can't grow when you're comfortable. Well, you grow best when you're uncomfortable, because it's causing you to have to move and deal with something. So expect to be a little bit uncomfortable, and that's okay, because that's going to get you closer to where you want to be. So be uncomfortable, deal with the emotions, and it's okay to cry. It's okay to feel different. It's okay to not have a word to express your emotions. I know also another way you could be uncomfortable is to do different types of practices. So sometimes people, and I'll give you guys this example, and I actually heard this from another YouTuber. I think her name was Leora Alexandria. And so one of the exercises that she offers is to kind of do like a puppet show with your hand, inner child, adult. No, Adult is the dominant hand, I believe, and it's the inner child. And you're having conversations like this, and it may feel uncomfortable, but it's proven, she says, to be effective. I haven't tried it, but you know, she said it's proven to be effective. And so you may feel uncomfortable doing these exercises, but if they're helping you out, I think it's great to do it. Now, don't do these with anybody else around, because that could be a little bit interesting to them. But I would say there could be certain types of methods to heal that could be uncomfortable, but just remind yourself it's part of the bigger picture, it's part of the process, and affirm yourself, right? So the other one is that depending on your wounds, and my heart goes out to everybody and anyone who has ever had any type of abuse, sexual or any type of abuse, physical abuse or anything, and it's not okay and it's not something easy to get over. So if you have some type of wounded inner child that is beyond just being able to be helped reading books, you know, watching YouTube videos or reading blogs, please, I ask you and beg of you, please make sure you get the help that you need. And that's okay. Another thing in that point is you may need support outside of just using those free resources. Sometimes you need to invest. No, not sometimes. Woohoo. Always. It's always good to invest in yourself, but you need to know when and how to invest in yourself. So in all of my videos, I am going to make sure that I include national hotlines for any type of like trauma so that you can get the help that you need. Don't feel bad about needing help, because again, sometimes trauma is very, very aggressive and you need help, and nothing is wrong with needing help at all. So I just wanted to keep that in mind, that if you need help, that's a possibility. You may start out being strong and then your inner child just opens up and the floodgates of trauma and wounds becomes overwhelming. That's very much true. It could happen, but just know that you have people there who are willing to help you and to not judge you. And then my last point is, guess what? You have to do the work. The expectation is you have to do the work. You can't expect to get results if you do not show up for yourself. You can't put this inner child work on anybody else. You have to first decide you want to do it. Once you decide you want to do it, you make a declaration to yourself that you will put your 100% effort into healing your inner child and being able to reparent yourself, because you will show up then as you. You will show up as the person you are meant to be, with no more bad and sabotaging and destructive behavioral patterns or anything. You will be able to be free. You will be able to make so much more progress in life. You'll feel so much more worth. And it's such an amazing feeling. And one thing I will say too is I'm not nowhere done inner child healing, but even the process and how far I've come in such a short period of time, I feel so much better. And two things, this is extra, so make sure you stay to the end. But one thing I will say is that, you know, through affirmations have really helped me. I feel like they've already kind of softened my inner child, because I know the subconscious, when you say things, you are what you think you become. So as I'm saying those, I realize I was softening my inner child. So the process of starting this out, it's going well so far. I feel a lot better about myself. I realize trigger points also, because there are certain things I may read, certain questions I might ask myself, and it's like immediate emotion. And there's a lot of different emotions that I realize that I'm going to experience during this inner child healing. Some of them are sad. Some of them are confused. Some of them are so, I just want to punch the air type thing. But I just realized that there's so many different emotions that go along with it. But I know that each emotion is for a reason. And I just know that, okay, let's deal with it. What is this coming from? What exactly was I feeling? And you know, it's good to get you a notebook. Get yourself a notebook. And so just as you're sitting down, or, you know, you're not even trying to do inner child work, your inner child could decide to show up through watching a movie, through a conversation, through hearing a podcast. However, you never know. So keep it there and just start documenting different things, because that will help piece the puzzle together in order for you to go ahead and continue to heal. So guys, as always, I thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for taking the time to check out this video. You know the subscriptions are helpful to me as well as the views. You know I love the comments and I love them to stay positive though, as I've stated before. I love the comments, but I love when they're considerate of other people. I love when they're uplifting because this is a very sensitive topic. So I love when you guys can communicate below or ask me questions and we can get talk chains going in order to support one another, because I think this type of journey does call for support. And I'm not saying a support of a therapist, I'm just saying the support of other people. I felt confident myself to start this by myself in the sense of without therapy or without a life coach or anything like that. And I'm hoping you'll do the same. So guys, until next time, you have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful day, and I will see you in the next video.